Welcome back to the Relax My Dog podcast. My name is Claire.
And my name's Leah.
And we are from Relax My Dog. We talk about all things dog. No, I actually can't remember what our blog was about. Our podcast was last week. Was it? Oh, obedience training, that was it.
Yeah.
Now, I think I mention this like every time we talk, we open or close a podcast, but if you guys aren't aware, we are actually on this podcast, it's actually on YouTube now, not just on Spotify. So if you guys want to listen to our podcast and then comment underneath, please feel free. I love reading all your nice comments. We always get like nice comments. I think we've got like one negative comment once, and that was someone complaining about someone else in the comments, so it wasn't even about us.
Of course, I remember you saying that. So yeah. I think nice comments are always the best to read.
Yeah, so if you guys want to comment and say how much you enjoy the podcast, that kind of thing, do go on to YouTube. It's all linked in the show notes, so if you guys want to go and check there. But we're also on Spotify too, which is also a fact too. But this week we're going to be talking about toy dog breeds. Now, I am such a sucker for toy dog breeds. I don't know about you, Leah.
Yeah, they are. It's kind of, I think, because obviously I'm used to having like quite a big dog, having a border collie, but whenever I see like a small like chihuahua or something, it's like mad how that's the same like type of animal. It's crazy.
Yeah. And you think like, you know, you think of like the quintessential dog and he comes to mind, maybe a Labrador or a collie or something, and then there's something that is so small, like a bit in a handbag, and it's like, that's a dog too.
I know, it is. It's insane. But they are so cute, aren't they?
Oh, they really are.
They're so small.
So we're going to actually be sharing some of the smallest dog breeds out there. And to be perfectly honest, I didn't know there was that many. So I'm actually quite surprised that there's this many. So that's really cool.
Yeah, definitely.
I think typically toy dog breeds are specifically bred, aren't they? There must be some dogs out there that are naturally quite small. I'm not really sure.
Yeah, I feel like if they were to be bred smaller, surely they'd have to be bred with a dog that's small. I don't know. I feel like that, the whole science behind it just baffles me, but... Yeah, I agree. There must be some out there that are just genetically smaller than others.
Yeah, I mean, there's lots of different like breeds that can have a toy category. Because I know there's like poodles and stuff, but I think typically a toy dog breed refers to a very small dog that's bred between 14 and 18 pounds, which is just adorable. So the first one is the mini schnauzer. Now, I am a big fan of schnauzers all around. Like, I love schnauzers. I just love their little beardy little faces. I just think they're so sweet.
Yeah, I agree.
And I came across recently a giant schnauzer, and I was like dumbfounded at just how, like, wow, a schnauzer is actually like huge. It's really crazy.
Really? I don't think I've ever seen a big one.
It's like, I'm trying to think how big it kind of is. I can't really, it's bigger than like a Labrador. They're like much bigger than a Labrador.
So, really?
Yeah, they're really, really big. And I was like, oh my God, it's a schnauzer, but it's huge. Very cool. But anyway, miniature schnauzers. So can't decide what's more endearing, the mini schnauzer's human-like eyes and bushy eyebrows, or distinguished beard and moustache, or its adorable stocky body. And if these attributes were enough to make a mini schnauzer the most favoured of the schnauzer breeds, they're outgoing, great with kids, and friendly. And it's just one of the many dogs that have the little beardy faces, which I am such a fan of. I think you'll find this typically with a lot of toy dog breeds, but their life expectancy is between 12 and 15 years, which is typical for a small dog, I think.
Yeah, I think the smaller the dog, they tend to live a bit longer, don't they? Whereas the bigger dog breeds tend to live not as long, which is obviously quite sad. But yeah, I love schnauzers. Well, for years when I was growing up, I always said when I get older, I really want to get a miniature schnauzer. That's like popped up on my list. I really wanted to get one. And they are really, really cute.
They really are.
It's the little ears, I think, like as well as the beard, it's the little floppy ears. It's like either side. It's just so sweet.
Yeah.
Now the next one is the toy American Eskimo. Now here's a shocker: the American Eskimo dog doesn't come from the frozen tundras of Alaska. Eskies, as they are known by Dorian fans, originally hail from Germany. They're undeniably cute, playful, perky, and quick at learning tricks. They tend to be quite protective with herding in their genes, but never in an "I'll nip your feet" kind of way. And that goes for the miniature and the standard varieties of the American Eskimos. I think this dog breed was in, there's a film with Sandra Bullock. Oh, The Proposal. There's a dog in
Oh.
that that's like a really small, kind of looks a bit like a Pomeranian, but a very like a
Oh.
white fluffy one. And it looks very similar to this. And I feel like that's probably the dog that's in there, because it's so small. And part of the film is that there's like an eagle that tries and gets it, because obviously it's quite a small dog. So I think that's this dog. But the average height is between 9 to 12 inches. They usually weigh between 6 to 10 pounds, which is miniature. And again, like Claire, so the life expectancy tends to be quite high. So they're 13 to 15 years for the life expectancy.
I suppose with the little puffball appearance, you see it could be a Pomeranian, but it's got a much bigger snout, hasn't it? It's got more like a sort of quote unquote normal dog's sort of snout, as a Pomeranian's got quite a tiny little snout,
Quite a
hasn't
small one. Yeah,
it?
I'd have to probably rewatch the film to know, but I think from remembering it, I think it looked more similar to this, but I never really knew there was a like a difference. So I feel like it probably was this dog.
It's very cute, very,
It
very
is. I love the
cute.
white fluffy fur, so
And
sweet.
like the little sticky up ears, I love that. It's
I
gorgeous.
know.
The next is the toy poodle. Now, I think a lot of people, when they think of toy breeds, they probably think of a toy poodle, because the thing is, a poodle, they come in all sizes, like much like the schnauzers. And I feel like poodles, or sort of, like labradoodles, or any sort of that's bred with a poodle, they're so popular nowadays. So it's actually very easy to come across something like a toy poodle. To be looking for an adorable toy dog breed that look like teddy bears, these fluffy little nuggets are about the same size as a stuffed animal, but much more cuddly and a whole lot more fun to play with. Now, maxing out at around 5 pounds, oh, that's so cute, and less
Hello.
than 10 inches tall, they're just as portable as your favorite teddy bear. They'll be your devoted sidekick for years. Many toy poodles live to their upper teens, and there is even one apparently that lives to 24, which is just quite.
Wow.
That's crazy. That's a whole person.
Literally.
Oh my gosh, that's like nearly your age, isn't it? Aren't you?
Yeah, well, I'm a little bit older than that, but yeah, almost.
So, gosh, the toy is the smallest of the poodle breeds. The next is the miniature, which is 10 to 15 inches tall, and the standard at about 15, but this is the smallest of the poodles, which is obviously the toy. I said it's about 10 inches maximum, 4 to 6 pounds, and life expectancy 10 to 18, which is like a really, really good life expectancy for a dog. Which, yeah, 18 years is really, really long for any sort of dog breed, really.
Yeah, that is amazing. What's like, because they say that 1 year is dog years, don't they? 7 years is a dog year. So what's that? So that means that the dog's 126 if they
Holy
make it
cow.
to 18, which is, that is just amazing.
That is wild.
I know. I think my friend's got a toy poodle, and they're very boisterous. He's very fun. He loves all his toys. He's very like, he is literally like a teddy bear. Sometimes when he's had his hair
Oh.
cut and he's all like fresh. He looks just like a little teddy bear. He is so cute.
That's adorable.
So the next is the Shih Tzu. Like if the name didn't give it away already, we'll let you in on a secret. The Shih Tzu is a mixed breed dog, a cross between a Shih Tzu and a poodle. That's among the cutest dogs that stay small. Like Claire said before, you'll find a lot of dogs will be mixed with them with poodles nowadays. You're getting the best of both doggy genes here, the super affectionate and charming traits of the Shih Tzu and the playful, comedic, smarty pants personality of the poodle. And a bonus is that both breeds tend to shed less than other dogs. So if you do have allergies, this is one of the best hypoallergenic dog breeds that you can get, which is really good. Now, in terms of that, the overview of the breed, they tend to be between 8 to 15 inches in height. Weigh between 7 to 20 pounds, which I think is quite a big difference, really. But obviously, it just depends on which one you've got. And I bet with mixed breeds, I don't actually know the science behind it, but is it usually 50-50, or can it sometimes be like 70-30? Because I feel like that would make sense why there's a bit of a difference in weight. You know, if it's a miniature poodle is usually closer to the smaller, and then a Shih Tzu is a bit heavier. Maybe it depends on what your percentage of your dog is, maybe. And then the life expectancy tends to be between 13 to 17 years. So again, a really, really good age for a dog.
Yeah, and they do look, they look like another breed. I can't for the life of me think of it right now, but it does look, I know, it's just like a cute little toy dog breed. Like, you wouldn't I think maybe he would look at it and think it was it. There's some Shih Tzu in it. I think a little bit of
Yeah.
facial Shih Tzu-y, but the little curly coat is obviously very poodly.
Yeah, it kind of looks a bit like a Maltese, but a curly version.
I think that's what I was thinking, like the Maltese. Yeah, so
Yeah.
I think we really sound like we know what we're talking about when it comes to dogs, don't we? I suppose we talk about dogs so much.
And they're literally.
Next is the Maltese. Now, those expressive eyes and outgoing spunky personalities, you would have to have a heart made of coal to resist a lovable miniature dog. Maltese are typically affectionate and charming, and they make good watchdogs and athletes. There is a drawback, though. The only drawback is that their adorable white fur requires daily brushing to prevent matting. But that just means that you get to spend more time with your little dog. And I do tend to find that small dogs actually quite enjoy being groomed. So it's actually quite a nice thing for you guys to do together.
Yeah.
Yes. They're about 7 to 9 inches tall, weigh under 7 pounds, and tend to live between 12 and 15 years. I love Maltese. I think they're so cute.
Yeah, they are really cute. I would never, I mean, they are a small dog breed, but I don't know. I would never have put, I don't know. I've never really thought about it too much before, but to me, they're more like a medium dog breed. But maybe that's something like a mix or one that looks just like a Maltese. It's a bit bigger. I don't
Oh,
know.
yeah, maybe it's just sort of on the edge of being one of the bigger ones. I'm not sure.
Yeah. And the next one is your favorite, Claire, which is the Papillon. Now I actually saw one of these recently and I remember thinking
Oh.
whoever I was with, I was like, that's Claire's favourite dog breed. I've never seen one before, but that's a Papillon. And I think they were amazed as well. They were like, how do you know what dog breed that is? I was like, I just know. I know it now.
We talk about them all the
Literally. Now Papillons are named after the French word for butterfly due to their wing-shaped ears. They are dainty and elegant, but can also make excellent agility dogs as well. They live to flaunt their stellar intelligence and agility while doing obstacle courses and obedience trails. Fortunately, Papillons don't have to compete outside of the home to be content. Feed their curious and alert minds with puzzle toys and new tricks, and they kind of need that mental stimulation quite a bit. And after you've done, snuggle those adorable ears. They are so cute. I think that's the one thing that you can always recognize a Papillon from,
Yeah.
at the other end of a field, because you can just see them ears straight away. You know what
Yeah.
kind of dog breed it is. I think even like the color, the markings of the dog is where you can kind of tell, because they're quite a particular
Oh,
marking thing.
yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Now in terms of height, they're usually between 8 to 11 inches. They usually weigh between 5 to 10 pounds, and their life expectancy is between 13 to 15 years, so pretty standard for a smaller dog breed.
Yeah, we had my husband and I had some friends over last night for a barbecue. Because my husband's a teacher, so he's off in the summer now, so we get to do some bits and pieces. And they brought their dog with them, and they don't know what she is. She's not a toy breed. They actually rescued her from Ukraine,
Oh,
which
nice.
is lovely. She's such a sweet dog. And she came to the barbecue, but obviously we don't have a lot of dogs in our house because we've got chickens and a cat and stuff. But I was thinking like. It got me thinking, like, God, I'd actually really like to get a dog. So now, obviously, I don't have my cat anymore. And now
Yeah.
that I've seen the Papillon today, I've taken that as a sign. So I might try and pursue
Oh,
that.
that'd be lovely. That'd be really nice.
Well, they're cat sized, aren't they? So it's not like they would take up any more room than my cat did. So.
That's a really, yeah, that's a good point. That's a good persuasion point as well to try and get one.
Yeah, and they're not like, even though it
Simplicity.
is a small dog, it's not like they're actually quite they're like they've got quite high energy, so they're quite going on long walks and stuff. So I'm gonna have to figure that
Yeah.
out.
Do you reckon you'd like know what you want to call them and stuff like that, or would you try and
Oh,
get
I
one
don't
reviewed?
know. Oh, I don't know. I guess I'd have to see the dog first and see like what I think it but my friend, someone on Facebook and that I've known for a few years, posted on about going to the vet with their dog called Biscuits the other day. I was like, that is a really cute name.
That is
Like,
really adorable.
isn't it just? So watch this space. I might have a puppy on at some point.
Oh, that'd be so nice.
Well, the next is the Chiweenie, which, oh, I just love saying that word. Chiweenie. So cute.
Oh,
We love a sweet teeny weeny dog toy dog breed. Does that give you a clue as to who its parents are? This designer mixed breed is a mix of Chihuahua and a Dachshund. Is also known as a Choksi. It's pocket size, but has a giant personality, which doesn't surprise me because both Dachshunds and Chihuahuas have big personalities. So,
Yeah, exactly.
yeah. Both breeds are known for their spunk and moxie and their fearless loyalty to their favorite humans. Chihuahuas and Dachshunds can be short or long-haired pups, and Chobeanies are the same. Their bodies tend to be shorter and robust, favoring the Chihuahua with the long, narrow tail of a Dachshund. About 6 to 8 inches in height, weigh between 5 and 12 pounds, and live as you also always and pretty typical for anything that's Chihuahua mixed is between 12 and 15 years. But look at that cute little face with those ears, it's so cute, like a Chihuahua with like floppy ears.
Literally, I didn't actually know these existed. I'd never heard of that dog breed before.
I've
But that
recently
is
come across
really
it.
cute.
A cute little face.
Literally, like you said, I can imagine them to be quite like a boisterous dog breed because both of those have big personalities themselves. So I can't even imagine what this dog's going to be like. And the next one is the Yorkshire Terrier. Now, a delightfully sweet and devoted companion that you can carry around in your tote. Sign us up. Yorkies love to be with their human, if that means a shopping trip to the local supermarket and a snazzy tote, so be it. Yorkies aren't likely to trigger allergies or shed too much, which is perfect. They can obviously be little yappers, which really just translates to lively and alert. And at least you'll know that your Amazon parcel has been delivered because they'll inform you straight away. Now, in terms of their height, they tend to be between 8 to 9 inches. They usually weigh between 4 to 6 pounds, so really, really small. And the life expectancy is between 13 to 16 years. So, again, a good age for a dog.
I think, yeah, if you are looking for a dog that you don't that you want a dog that's going to live a long life. You know, if you get a dog, if you've got a child, you know, to grow up with it, getting a small dog, it really does make sense, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
So next is the pug, and everyone loves pugs, don't they? They're just so super adorable. So the pug motto is "Multum in Parvo," which translates to "a lot in a little." Oh, I love that. That's so cute. And we couldn't agree more. They are typically happy and energetic dogs with adorable facial expressions. And by energetic, we don't necessarily mean physical. Truth be told, they would rather cuddle than do anything strenuous. They're energetic in the sense that they are extroverts, animated and gregarious, making their rounds at gatherings and entertaining the masses, which is just typical pug, absolutely.
Definitely.
They're between 10 and 15 inches tall, 14 to 18 pounds, and live to between 12 and 15, which is, we're finding, is pretty typical of these kinds of breeds.
I just love pugs. I think they just
Yeah.
have so much character about them, don't like every single pug has it looks like it has a story to tell, and I love how you can always hear them come in because
Oh,
they're
yeah.
either snoring or making some sort of noise.
I love
No.
And stay tuned next week for part two of Toy Dog Breeds, where Leah and I will continue to share with you some of the best toy dog breeds. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week.